friends, in previous video tutorial I have discussed about arrays. In this video tutorial we are going to create our own custom functions. So let's first clean this. Let me remove this. Okay, so let's suppose you have a registration page in your website and you want to provide a system generated password to your user. So how can you achieve this? For this we need to create a function that could generate a password, a random password. Okay, so for that we need to create that function. So the function name could be anything. Let's say function generate random password. Okay, this is the function and it is similar to any other function we create in other programming languages such as C# and Java. The only difference, we use function keyword to define a function. Okay, and it ends with a double bracket. Okay, now inside this chain bracket all the required code should be mentioned. So the purpose of this is to create random password. Okay, so how can we achieve this? For this we need to create one array that should hold all the alphabets, numbers, special characters. Okay, so let's say key set, otherwise let's say key values. This is an array. Okay, we declare an array like this. Let's create all the alphabets A, so here we have stored in this array, key values array, all the alphabets in lowercase. Okay, now let's put alphabets in capital letter because we want to provide a password combination of alphabets in lowercase, alphabets in uppercase, various special characters along with numbers. Such passwords are strong passwords. Okay, we have stored all the alphabets in uppercase. Now we need to store numbers. So 0, nine. Now let's store some special characters. Okay, that's enough. Okay, so we have an array and the array variable name is key values. This array variable contains all these values. So to generate a random password, all we need to do is, let's say we want to provide a password that is 8 in length. For this we need to create a loop, for loop. Okay, for $i is equal to 0, $i less than 8 semicolon. Why 8? Because we want a password of length 8. Okay, then $i plus plus. So at the end of each loop it should increment the value of I to 1. Now first declare one empty variable. So let's say password is equal to empty. This is one empty string, it contains nothing, it's a empty string. Okay, at the end of each loop we want to pick one value randomly of this array. Okay, so how can we pick that value? For that, key values, we need to pass one index number here. So instead of passing one index number, what we can do, we can generate a random number. So rand is the function provided by PHP. We can run in between 0. So this function calculates a random number between two values. So the first value would be 0, the second value would be the count, and the variable name is $keyValues. Okay, minus 1, because the index number begins from 0, that's why we have deducted 1 from this value. Okay, now this function will return a random number between 0 and the total number of data available in this array. By this we can randomly pick these array values. Okay, Let me show you first. Echo this dot br. Br is the break tag. Okay, let's see the output. Okay, it's not printing. What happened? Okay, this is not printing because we have defined a function, but we have not called a function. Okay. Now run this. See, we got these values Q, J, G, A, B, Y, M, G. Okay. If I refresh this again, the value would change. See, 40, 4G, O, 0, Y, H. See, it generated again new array values. Okay. So what now? We need to combine all these values into one single string. So how can we achieve this? For this, we need to concatenate each value we get in each loop. Okay. Now we need to remove this one dot br. Okay. In first loop, whatever value we get, that is stored inside this password. And in second loop, the new value would be concatenated with the previous value. So what I mean is, let echo this password dollar password. Okay. Now when we call this function, it would print the password. Let's see. See, the new password generated is KCLG7XTS. Okay. So in many cases, we want to provide a user a system generated password. So this function is very useful. So in this function is printing password to the web page. Instead of printing, we can return the password as string. Okay. All we need to do is just use the return keyword. Now we need to echo the value. Okay. So it will print the value. Okay. See, it's printing the value. Okay. So what we have done here, instead of printing the password, generated password inside this function, we are returning this password as a string value. So whenever we call this function, it would return a string value of password. It would return a string value, and that is the generated password. Okay. So we can mention echo system generated password is. Now we need to use dot, because we are concatenating two strings. Okay. Now here, generate random password. This is the function, semicolon. Now run this. See, it is saying system generated password is this. Okay. So this way we can define our own custom functions for various purposes. Okay, friends, I hope you have understood how to create your own custom functions in PHP script. If you have any questions, comment below. In next video tutorial, we are going to discuss few other beneficial functions provided by PHP, using which we can easily achieve various requirements, okay, that we may need in our web development projects. Okay, friends, thank you.